Same thing with full guard. However, you decided to full guard, doesn't matter. Full guard. I control my partner's sleeve. Now, what we're gonna do here, guys? I want to get to a position that is called Tarantula Guard, which is just it's a variation of Spider Guard. It's a position I learned in San Diego from Dominic Bell, and it's worked very well for me. And so I just want to show you guys this month kind of how the guard works. So what we're gonna do, guys, is I'm gonna take my almost like I'm gonna do a scissor sweep. Okay, I'm gonna bring my right foot onto the mat. I'm just gonna start to hip out a little bit just to get my knee past the shoulder here. So if you see, my hand is kind of pushing her shoulder away while my knee comes through, and I'm just stepping on her hip. Once my knee comes through, I'm gonna be pulling, trying to keep her nice and tight to my shin. I don't want her like moving away and getting up or anything like that right now. I'm gonna do the same thing with my other foot, bringing my knee inside, my foot on the hip, and I'm gonna use my shin to break this grip on my collar. Now from here, guys, I'm just gonna step on the bicep. Now at this point, if Kalea just like stays where she is, which is not wise, it's a very easy triangle for me. So most likely what's gonna happen here almost every time is they're gonna stand up. But before you stand up, just so you guys can see, the triangle is just me pushing my leg through and pulling on the collar, and there's your triangle. But more often than not, you're gonna find that the person stands up when you start opening your guard because it's harder to attack. For me, if she stands up, right? So for now, guys, what we're gonna do now, when she stands up, is I'm gonna take my foot and I'm gonna step between her legs. When I do this, I can do like a bridge and I'm gonna pull with my grips. When I pull, my goal is to get her to step over top of me, but I don't want her directly over top of me. I'm gonna favor my left side a little bit. So it's gonna be like this. So I'm like kind of facing this way just a little bit. And now what I'm gonna do, guys, is I'm gonna bring my toes, I'm keeping my grips, I'm pulling, while I'm keeping my knee locked out here, I'm pulling, I bring my toes in from under her butt, and like I wanna step like on her belly button with my toes. So my knee is out, but my toes are in. Kinda like an X guard hook. And from here, guys, all I'm doing is I'm pushing with my foot to lift her hip, while kinda steering the upper body. And then we can ride up the position to like whatever you want, really. There's knee on belly. You can go to side control, you can go to mount. Most likely, after you sweat, stay there. As you come up, they're gonna start re-guarding. You're gonna end up in some sort of like half guard or something a lot of the time when you're sparring. But you can practice it however you guys like, right? You can have the person on the bottom practice recovering a little bit. Or if you wanna just work on getting to a certain position, you guys can do that as well. So I pull close guard, gripping the sleeve and the collar still. Place my foot on the mat so that I can hip out. As I hip out, I'm bringing my knee inside while pushing her shoulder away. Once I come through, I'm pulling. My goal is just to keep as much contact with my shin on her chest so that she can't like get away. I'm trying to move here. It's very hard. If I'm relaxed here, she'll start smashing my knee down exactly and start passing. So I need to keep it up to the roof. Very important. Foot's coming inside. As I do that, my knee comes inside too. Break the grip. Step on the bicep. She stands up. I place my foot on the mat between her legs. I pull her over me. Toes come inside. I lift. Come on. It's a knee on belly or whatever you guys want, guys. A lot of the time too, I find like as you come up, it's easy to just cross your arms and just come up into to chest to chest pressure as well. Do you need to see? Dax back for me. Pull guard. You can even, guys, on the guard pull, even take this sleeve grip if you like. I do that sometimes as well, so I don't always have to control my elbow. I can control the sleeve. Pull guard. Break the grip. Again, I'm just hipping out, pushing your shoulder away as I bring my knee inside, and I'm pulling both grips. Keep them nice and tight to me. Knee comes inside, foot on the hip. You'll probably be holding my collar here. Break that grip. Step on the bicep, he stands up. My foot goes to the mat. pull him over me. And now, guys, for the person on top, just for your guys' understanding of how you're gonna move, it's basically like you're gonna be doing a shoulder roll over the shoulder that I have my foot on your bicep. Does that make sense? So you're gonna look that way as you go over your shoulder.
Do you need to see again?
No.
Anybody need to see again? No. All right, guys, let's do it on 2.2.